Welcome everyone. I'm starting to put together my videos, excuse me, on soldering up these DB9 connectors for my stepper motors. First of all, I suppose I probably should go over my home-built helping hands, I guess, if you want to put it. Setup I got going here to help hold things. I got an old magnifying glass sitting up on the magnetic base for my dial and test indicator. Got a 1-2-3 block with the C clamp holding a pair of hemostats bolted to the side. Try to save where I can, I suppose. I'm really not cheap, but there wasn't no need of going out and spending $5 or $6 for a helping hands little thing that I'll probably never ever use again. This is all stuff that I already have, so right now I'm waiting on my soldering iron to get warm. I'm going to be tinning these four wires here. It's coming off the X-axis stepper. I'll go over a few things here first. I have already got one of them done. This one here, it's all set up. It's all soldered up. I got the, if you look close at it, you can pull this back a little bit. I got the heat shrink on it as well. All the way from the stepper motor up just inside the shell. It kind of acts as a grommet, kind of that way, keeping out debris and coolant and what have you. Probably should point out, those that don't know, that anytime you're wiring up things like this, you should always say, for example, these stepper motors, you want to run a female band on it. If you look at the back of your PC or just about anything that you purchase at the store, electronics wise, will always have a female end on it. Your plugs will always have a male end on it, and there is reasons for that. I won't go into that right now, but in future videos I'm going to be putting together on electronics of a few different things, so we'll cover that and go over that. And as I mentioned, this one is done. It's ready to go. What's going to happen is it's going to mount a thing here. Put a clamp on the side there, and another one up a little bit yonder. A little further up the base there. And this is what the ends look like. Those that's not familiar with it, I don't know if I could actually zoom this in enough for anybody to actually really see. These are referred to as cups. And as you can see, they are very small. They're going to be quite challenging for me to solder up. Done one, it wasn't too bad. Behind this magnifying glass, it does help. Definitely takes a steady hand, which I pretty much have a steady hand these days. Far as these wires here, I've got these ready to tin. Those not familiar with tinning, it's nothing more than putting like a, what be called a pre-solder as well. You always want to make sure your ends are twisted on it too. Some people don't. Some people like to keep them straight, but they'll get caught up on your pin then as you're putting it in. But the tinning, you just get your soldering iron hot. Get some buildup on the end of your soldering iron, and you just tap the wire just to put a little bit of solder on your wire. You do the same to your pin, whichever pins that you're going to need to use. You just want to fill the cup Some people prefer to fill it all the way. Some people just fill just a little on the end, just enough to hold the wire in. I go about halfway. It don't take much. The cup is open on that one side, if you can see that or not in this shot here. I don't know if you can see that. I do believe you could, though. And this would be on an angle this way here. And you just take them four cups that run across, you put a drop of solder in each one of them, and then you let it cool. And then you put this up on the clamp in this direction here. And you grab the wires that you need to use, and whichever one it goes in. And you just lay that wire right on top of that cup to where it goes, and just set your iron on top of the wire for a second, and it'll melt it, and it secures the joint, then it's done. And then you just move on to the next one and follow the same steps. The only thing you really got to watch out, there's a few things, but you got to be careful putting the solder on here, is you don't want to bridge them. Obviously it was short circuit. In the G540, it's got fault protection, so it wouldn't hurt nothing. It would set the fault code and let you know where your problem is at, and that stepper just wouldn't work. That's something to keep in mind, is look for a bridge and make sure you don't got a bridge running across your, from you putting your solder in there. And you don't want to get it too hot. This insulation will melt. And on this case here, there's 9 pins. We're only using 4. The bottom 4 that you see here is 6, 7, 8, and 9. And they go from the left, black, red, green, and blue. And when I get up to the other end, that has the mill in. This is the actual mill in here. On the opposed side, them 4 wires will be soldered in, and on the opposed side here, between pin 1 and 5, is if you recall in one of my other videos, this set current resistor will be soldered into here. You just bend the leads over, kind of like how I got it in the center there. Now I try to eyeball in the center and take it from one of those pliers and bend the leads over, snip the ends, fill your cup. You don't need to retin this first. Just fill your cup. Put this up on your clamp. Hold it in place while you're moving. Try to center it between the two cups, get one cup hot and push it down in it. Head over to the adjacent side, the opposite side rather, and repeat the process. Get that cup hot, push it down in it, and it's done. It's not hard to do none of these, and it's dirt cheap. I think these connectors are only like 50 cents each. That's a wiring. My step ring wire is a different color. They didn't have the exact same, and it don't really matter. It's gotta keep track of your difference. On the original steppers, we got red, black, green, and blue. And on this wire in here, you can see we got red, black, green, and white. So white will go into blue, obviously. All the rest colors would be a coordinate, so that'd be fine there. I won't take a chance of making a mistake there. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this up on the tripod. Yeah, I'm going to tin these wires here real quick, like. See if the soldering gun is hot yet. I don't think it's quite hot yet. You put water on a... Yeah, it's melting it. Put water on a on a sponge like that, and it deoxidizes the tip of it. I'll put this on the tripod here in a few and be going on these bad boys, get them done. Hey guys, I get set up on the tripod now. I'm going to tin these four wires. This will be a fairly quick process. I'll get these tin. I got to reset this hemostats up on a different angle. And then I'm going to fill them cups on that DB9 connector. You just want to melt a little bit on your iron. You go up and just drag it across the wire, and as you can see, they're kind of melted off the iron. There's a few different ways of going about this. It don't take much, just to put a little dab on the end of it. I am kind of new at soldering too, so bear with me. A lot of times you don't want to roll off of it. It rolls right off of it. Hate it when that happens. There's a little more on this one. Should be good to go. That'll work. Just let them cool for a couple seconds. It don't take but a minute. I'm going to change this clamp around and all these hemostats and get that DB9 connector in there and fill them cups. And then I'll solder these wires to it. Alright, about all set up on this DB9 connector to get these soldered up. One thing I forgot to go over in that video prior to this, before or after you tin your stepper wires or any of the wires that you're doing, if you plan on heat shrinking them, you're going to want to slide your heat shrink over your wires prior to wiring them up to connector. Obviously, if you don't, you're SOL. You have to pull your connector back off or cut the wires and start all over and put a piece of your heat shrink over top of that. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to fill these cups, 6, 7, 8, 9. Not completely fill them, but just put a little bit of solder in them. Being careful not to bridge them. It's fairly easy to do. It don't take but just a dab of solder in each cup. A lot of people will put their gun actually right on the connector and run their solder into it that way. But you want to try to avoid contact as much as possible, because you'll melt that insulation around it. Buying a good used car is all about having the right information and facts. And if it's a Honda certified used car, well, it just got a whole lot easier. Because now you can find out the history, mileage, and the price. It'll be starting, it'll be a blue-green, or a blue-red, green, and black. Honda certified used cars. You'll see the current selection at the Honda. Blue will run to your number 9 connector.
Honda certified used cars. It may be used, but it's still a Honda.
Yeah, you just set the connector on there just enough to melt that solder. What I do is I just let it set for a second to cool.
It's their 14th anniversary this Saturday. They're going to have music from a penis dump your boyfriend.
Before you go to your next one. They appear to be quite delicate, but they're pretty strong. They don't take much solder to hold these. Process till it's done. Blue, red. Green. Black, the last one. I'll do here's a little bit more solder on it. That's all there is to it. It's pretty easy to do. On all these stepper wire motors, it's just male joint, you know, up with female. When I get up to putting the males on with the control, it's gonna run into the G540. Current set resistors will go on there. Now just pretty much place them in the center of between pin number 1 and 9, which is your furthest two outside ones. Took a pair of needle nose pliers, bend them over, cut it. I'll go over that when I get to that step though. I want to get this tube worn. And what you could do now is you could take something fairly small. For an example, I'm just going to go ahead and use a piece of this wire from these connectors and go right up in between each one of them pins that you just soldered. Make sure the wire moves freely in between them. Just double checking to make sure there's not a bridge of solder in there. And if there was a bridge, it would trip the gecko. G540, it's got circuit breaker. It's all protected, circuit protected and stuff, so you really don't have to worry about it ever doing anything. It would just go into fault. And it set the code and it tells you exactly what it does, pretty much. Pretty awesome piece of equipment. Gecko's got their own breakout board and everything, too, so it's kind of like a plug-and-play, I suppose you could say. It pretty much does anything and everything. It's a four-axis controller. And that's all I'll need, probably. Eventually, if I do upgrade to needing more accesses, at that point, I'll probably upgrade and get a bigger mill as a result as well. That pretty much covers this video though here, and what I'll do is I'll go ahead and put this in the shell. Once I get this in the shell, before I screw the shell together, I'll show you how this sets in the shell too, that people that's not aware how to do this. What I do is before I put it in the shell, I'll go back and you could either use a hot gun, you could use the iron itself. a lighter. In my case, I'll just use an old lighter I got. You know, heat this heat shrink up all the way around on this. Prior to putting it in the shell. Because when it goes into the shell, let me open up one here for you so you can see what I'm talking about. When I put this into the shell, this sets up in the shell like this. I'll bring this heat shrink up a little bit, like up in here. That heat shrink will shrink around that wires and it kind of pretty much forms. A seal and basically around the where the shells go together like this. They had grommets for these, but I didn't get the grommets because I didn't know for sure what the total diameter would be, the outside of this and the total diameter with the heat shrink on it. I didn't want to crimp none of the wires doing that, so the heat shrink will basically work as a grommet. There shouldn't be no problem as far as coolant getting in any of these anyways. Pretty much it wouldn't hurt anything. The Deco 540 would immediately recognize it. Wouldn't be much of a problem that I'd be too concerned about, so. But I'll put them together here pretty soon and show you what it looks like at the heat shrink, all heat shrunk on it. I could do that probably off camera. Those that don't know how to heat shrink, it's simple to do. Just heat it up and it shrinks. Go figure. But I'll get back on the next ones here pretty soon. Alright guys, I'm going to put the show on here now. Got the heat shrunk. Pretty much running right all the way up to the end of the stepper motor. Before putting your piece in there, there's these little retainers.
You got the tickets, my friend. Great, outstanding, wonderful. What's a station get you on the road to WrestleMania?
Ultra small, these real small little clips here. What you do is lay it in the wire, one direction. One side's got a flare on it with threads in it. One side don't. Go on opposite sides. It's a bit tricky to get them started. They are really small. What I normally do. You can see I've got one side started here, one screw in it. And I'll get it up to where it's just on that insulation for that heat shrink. Flip it over. In this case, you just turn the clamp. Do the same thing on the other side. Fairly easy to do. Hopefully you can hear me. It don't matter the way it goes here. What I normally do is once I soldered, I keep them on top. So when you set it in the shell, you know that's your top. Bring your end up to where it's really close to the end. It could be a little bit closer even. In this case, I will go just a little bit more. Extremely tight. tight, just tight enough where the screw goes down and it stops. That's what it looks like then. We can put that on there. My four connectors are on the top. On the shell, inside the shell, there's a lip right there. That lip will catch the inside there. And then what I'll do here is I push that up. Double that wire a little bit. As long as you're not binding up the wire too much, it's not going to hurt nothing. It'll kind of look like that. Wires could have been a little bit shorter. It's not going to hurt anything. They're not binding. None of the pins are rubbing against each other. Wires are still straight. Just taking and set your other one on top of it. Making sure that clip's on the front side of it. Flush here. In this case here, it don't matter which side you go on. Probably one thing I should point out before I go any further. On these, I'm not using no screws, but what you would want to do here, before you put that your cover on and attach these screws together, you just lay your thumb screw. I'll pull it back off here real quick, like. You lay your thumb screw down in that hole before you put that top shell on. Get that down in there straight. But in this case, I'm not putting the thumb screws on these connectors, and we'll go on just the connectors where they heat up the G540. Being as I know this is my top, then I'll go ahead and just lay that nut. It's got a recess on the back side of it. To recess and hold that nut, and actually does a fairly good job of it. And plastic, we all know how that normally works out. Once again, not too well. Repeat the process for the other side. Back and snug them up. They don't have to be extremely tight. There's no worrying about having a screw in your connector in the end or anything there. When these will meet together with the metal, they fit so tight. They just sit together like that. You don't have to run a screw in between them. You can buy longer screws. They have them on the website where I got these. Where if you would want to, you just run a longer screw with a nut on the back side to hold them together. It's not necessary though. Not in my case at least. So what I do now is this one's done. It's pretty much got a pretty good seal on the back side. As far as not needing the grooming, I should be alright there. What I'll do next now is I'll go ahead and put that covering over top of it. Like I did this one here. And then my X and Y will be done. I'm going to do my Z. I'll pull it back down off the mount, set it down here on the table to work on it so it'll be easier to get to. I'll put one more short clip together on soldering up these ends here because they're different colored wire. For those, just for reference, should they need to do as I'm doing with the different color coded wire, it's all the same except for white will go to blue, where blue would be on your stepper motor. And that's pin 9, so it's easy to remember after you've done it a few times. And then what I'll do is I'll put one more group together on when I get up to the other end. for the controller. Get these current set resistors soldered in to pin one and between pin one and five. It's done the same way as doing these. The pins are identical there, and all you would do is just flip it over on that other side, and you fill them cups prior to doing it. Lay your set resistor in there, pre-fit ahead of time first, so you know it's going to fit right in there. Bend it over, cut the leaves to the length, just so it sets down in your cover. And there's plenty enough room in the cover where they could be a little bit long. You could go a quarter inch to a half inch, probably even, and get away with that. And you just heat up one at a time, push it down into the pin, heat up the other side, push it down into the pin, let it cool, and repeat the same processes here and put it all back together, and it's done. It's a fairly straight up subject. It's their job. It's easy to do. It's not really that complicating. As I mentioned, I'm kind of a rookie at soldering too, so even for me it was pretty much a piece of cake. As I do with a lot of different things that I'm not familiar with, well in advance before I do anything, as I do a lot of research. I'll get online and see about how to solder this up, if there's any quick techniques, what I should do, what I shouldn't do. That pretty much sums it up, I believe. See you in the next video, guys.